Hello, I'm Stephanie with MyTime Fitness, and today I have some exercises for you that will help strengthen your pelvic floor. You won't need anything at all for this workout besides a mat if you don't have a soft surface to lie on because it is entirely floor work. There's no more cool down, so please get each of those in. You can grab some motivating music because this isn't going to be the most fun of workouts, but very important. If you haven't, hit that like and that subscribe button right now, and you can also find me on Instagram, TikTok, and Patreon. Let's get into it. All right, we're gonna get started with our very first exercise, which is a posterior pelvic tilt. So that means we're gonna lay on our backs. We're doing 10 reps per each exercise here. We're gonna take it nice and slow. So if you want, you can put your hands on those hips, and we're just going to bring up those hip bones. So you're gonna feel them go up, and then you're gonna tilt them back towards your mat. So your lower back will be up off that mat. And we're just going to back and forth with that tilt. Just take it all at your own pace. Really squeeze when you're tilting forward. And try not to rush through each range of motion. One more. All right, we're going to turn over and get on all fours for a tabletop. And while we're here, we're going to do a pelvic clock. So you're gonna take your, you're gonna move your hips from 9 to 3 or 3 to 9. And then you're gonna take them and move them from 6 to 12. We're gonna go back to 9 and 3. 6 and 12. You can change up these movements as well. Go from 3 to 9, from 12 to 6. It's up to you. We have 2 more. All right, and we're done with those. Next up, we're going to stay here for bird dog pulses. So for that bird dog, you're going to do left arm, right leg, and we're going to pulse here for 2. Then we're going to switch to right arm, left leg, and pulse for 2. Get a nice squeeze up at the top. Mm-hmm.
Also, if you want to break it apart, you can do one arm at a time and one leg.
Alright, next up we're going to come down back to our backs, and we're going to put our feet close together, and we're going to just drop that left leg as your knee is bent, and you're going to bring it back up. We're just going to stay on that left side, and then we'll go to our right. Just let that leg control the drop as far as it is comfortable. Don't push past anything, especially if there's any pain. One more. All right, let's switch to that right side, same thing. We are going to only go through these exercises one time through, but you can complete them a few times through, especially if you have the time. You can always just replay this and follow along again. The more you do this, or the more you implement it into your weekly workout routine, you're going to see results and a stronger pelvic floor. All right, next up we have a bent knee march. So we're going to stay right here, keep those feet on the ground, and you're going to come up and back down. Up and down. Again, nice and controlled. Keep those knees bent. Bring them just to about your hip and back down. You don't want to go in further. Also, make sure you keep that back press into your mat. And about two more. Then we're going to get into a heel tap. So it's similar, but a little different. All right, so for those bent knee heel taps, we're going to have our knees up, core tight, being that 90 on those legs, and you're just going to come and tap your heel down. Tap the heel down. Keep that core tight, back press into the mat. If you want to, you can also keep those heels, you can keep those feet down, and you can just do one foot at a time.
up to you. All right, and next up we have
double dead bugs. I'm gonna hold on my legs real quick. So for that dead bug, we're going to be in the same position,
those 90s
on those legs, arms up, and it's basically the opposite. Well, it's the same thing as a bird dog, except we're on our backs. So right arm, left leg, you come up. Do that same side again, and then left arm, left leg, and again. Make sure that back is pressed into that mat. You can also put everything down and you can do it one at a time, like we did for that bird dog, split it all apart. Or you do this same thing at the same time, just with one at a time. Oops, probably help if I'm confused myself now. Well, there's a couple ways that we can do it. And then we are going to finish up with a bridge pulse. So we're going to bring those heels as close to our knees as possible. We're going to press it up. We're going to let it hover. Arms up to make it more difficult. You're going to press it up. Do two pulses. Back down. Just let it hover. If you need a break, you can set all the way down on the mat. Really squeeze at the top. Just two more, and we're finished. All right, and that is it with our pelvic floor strengthening exercises. I really hope you enjoyed this. Like I said, it's not the funnest of workouts, but if you grab that motivating music, it will be a lot more fun, and it'll go by super quick. And like I said, if you do have more time, you can do this another time through, or three times through, four times through. It's up to you. Or just implement this into your weekly workout routine. Maybe do it a few times a week, and you're going to see a huge difference over time. So, but again, if you're finished, make sure you get in that cool down. It is very important. Lots of water, nice healthy meal. I really hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that you come back to work out with me again tomorrow. If you haven't, hit that like and that subscribe button right now. I appreciate all your support, and you can find me on Instagram, TikTok, and Patreon. Thanks.